Well, I lost my baby sister last night. It's a natural process. I had long talks with her about what happens when we die. I think she understood quite well what I was saying. So my mom, when she died, had incredibly bad lung problems. My sister Melody died of lung cancer. My baby sister Terry died of lung problems, and I have severe lung problems. This comes from, you know, a lifetime of driving up and down the road in Matheson, California, between Shasta Dam and Iron Mountain Road, driving on a material that came from the number two site on the Superfund cleanup list. I tried to leave a message today. There was a meeting about the water project around here and what to do, and I wasn't informed, or I would have been there with my samples. Because officials don't want to hear anything that I have to say. Now, I grew up on the Selby slag pile. I know exactly what that material is. I'm intimately familiar with it. I know what it looks like, smells like, and I know what it tastes like. Driving on those roads my whole life, we ground it into a fine powder that we had in our ears, our nose, our lungs, our mouth. It was in our food. It was in everything because their dust was everywhere. Okay? I told Fisher Game about it. They didn't want to hear about it. They basically put their fingers in their ears, literally put their fingers in their ears, and said, we don't want to hear about it. It's not our job. I told KRCR-TV, the news organization in my town, about it, and they didn't want to hear about it when I sent them an email. They never responded or got back to me. So I missed the meeting that was in town. The next one's in Sacramento, and it's incredibly hard for me to travel. And so, you know, I'm not going to make it down there for the in-person meeting, or I would walk down there with these samples and material that I have in my hand right here. Now, I went out there and I was told by an owner who was concerned that he was told it came from the brown mine. This material came from the brown mine. This is all over out there. And yes, this did come from the brown mine. Okay? But the problem is a vast majority of the material that's out there did not come from the brown mine. Okay? It came from the Selby slag pile. And as you can see, they are considerably different. Okay? See that? One is this light. It's very light and airy, like a very light rock. This feels like a chunk of steel. See the difference? Okay? This came from the Selby slag pile, the number two site on the Superfund cleanup list. And boy, did they clean that up. They gave those people 24 hours to get out of their homes, and they fucking bulldozed them. That was when I was a kid. Then they fenced the whole area off. The trouble is we walked on the railroad tracks from Crockett to Rodale constantly. That's how we traveled. And we walked past that Selby slag pile every single day. We played on it. We fished on it. We ate lunch on it, which is why I have all the health problems I have. This is from the slag pile. You can see it. It's very heavy, like a piece of steel. This is very light, like a regular rock. You can see the difference. This came from the brown mine. This came from the Selby slag pile. Now, this also came from the Selby slag pile. You can see it looks like melted metal, doesn't it? Huh? You see that? Full of toxic heavy metals and materials. Well, guess what? They pushed hundreds and hundreds of thousands of tons of that material into our water supply in Keswick Reservoir. To reclimate that would probably cost billions of dollars, which is why they don't want to talk about it, most likely. No one wants to hear what I have to say about that, and no one wants to verify what I'm saying about that. But you see, I'm 110% confident. Why? Because I'm intimately familiar with that material. Intimately familiar. Okay? I'm as intimate with that material as anything in my life. Why? Well, Like I said, we ate on it, played on it, fished on it for decades. Decades, people. Which is why I have so many friggin' health problems. There's no doubt in my mind, okay? I was treated for all kinds of weird fucking shit, and they never have been able to trace down the cause, and I've told them why. They tested my blood 10 years ago for heavy metals, and there weren't any because, well, I hadn't been exposed to that material in 25 years. And so, you know, it had flushed out of my blood. Also, they took blood out of me for a year, treating me for hemochromatosis. And that has you make more blood. That also flushed a vast majority of it out because I didn't get tested till after they did that. So if there's any public official out there that wants to talk about this fucking problem, which I doubt there is, okay, you can simply leave a comment here with your name, phone number, whatever you want, and I'll contact you, okay? If you call me and you're not in my address book, I will simply ban you, okay? Again, I sent KRCR, our news organization, a letter telling them, hey, let's talk about this. They didn't want to hear it. Fish and Game didn't want to hear it. Police didn't want to hear about it. Nobody wanted to hear about the issue that is I consider to be quite serious. And so what they did was they hauled that Selby slag up here on barges, and they used it to cover the road. It used to be railroad tracks following the lower road there below the Shasta Dam. And the material would get whoop-de-dooey, and Jim Fader, who's used to own the Suzuki shop, he's dead now. I knew him for, 50 years. He would take his bulldozer and basically push that shit into the river en masse, and then it would bring more up. Now, they stopped doing that quite soon after, you know, I don't know, maybe somebody said, we better stop doing that. But they stopped moving that material up there. That did not stop Jim Fader from pushing that shit into the fucking river every time the roads got whoop-de-dooey, okay? Because it's literally the road and then the edge of the road into Keswick Reservoir, where our water supply comes from in California. So people don't want to talk about it. I understand that, okay? Or I do a video about it. No one wants to fucking talk about it. If you guys want to help, you could pass this video around, and maybe that will get some ears listening, okay? I tried to leave a comment. Now, the water project people were here. I didn't hear about this meeting at the Veterans Hall, or I would have been there with my samples. It would have been the perfect opportunity. Now the rest are virtual or in Sacramento. Well, I didn't see an information about how to fucking get on there virtually on the news app. It said, leave a comment. I tried to leave a comment. Oh, it wants to sign up something that shares my information about me. Yeah, fuck you. So I'm left to do this. Leave a public comment. Okay, because it's my only recourse. Because people don't want to talk about it. Why? Because it's a $1 billion problem. That's why. So, you can still find that material out there, which is where I got these samples. After they cleaned it up, paved the road, you fucking name it, man. They tried to cover that shit up big time. But all you'd have to do is just step off the road and there'd be all kinds of it. There's also still samples laying on the sides of the road where they didn't cover it, didn't clean up stuff perfectly in the culverts, that kind of thing. Yeah, they brought up, there was a pile there that was 80 feet fucking tall and 400 foot around of that exact material that they would use to do the road constantly, okay? I don't know whose job that was to do it, but they did it for a very long time until I was 20, when they stopped, okay? So, yeah, our family suffered severe lung problems from all of this. Everybody who lived out there at my grandpa's mining claims, we had the last mining claims out there between Shasta Dam and Iron Mountain Road. We had the last mining claims because we're Wintu Indians. My grandfather's walked off the Pitt River Indian Reservation wearing buckskins and went to work building the dam. Then they got property out there and started mining. They were all prolific alcohol victims, of course. And yeah, they bulldozed the cabins as soon as they could to get us out of there. And I know why. I'm not going to mention the other reason why they booted us out of there and lied to my Aunt Agnes and told her, if you sign these quitclaim deeds, it will save you lots of money and you could still go out there. Federal agents came to my Aunt Agnes's house and had her, who was senile, sign our mining claims, which were patent mining claims, back over to the government. And that was to get us the fuck out of there, okay? So yeah, pretty ugly episode. Although I had grand times out there, I really did. So many of my childhood and young adult memories are from out there at the cabins, fishing, lots of fishing out there, lots of hunting out there. Awesome, just beautiful, beautiful. So anyway, if anyone wants to contact me about it, just leave a comment here. And I'll get back to you.